This Roseville intersection back open in all directions, and the cleanup is complete following a gas line fire that lit up the road for 7 hours. It started last night along Cirby Way and Riverside Avenues. Crews spent the morning repairing the line and cleaning up the asphalt, which had melted during the fire. It started when a 4-inch gas line broke. This is what the fire looked like last night from above, and Live Cop 3 HD with these exclusive pictures of the fire, flames literally coming up from under the street. And just over a year ago, there was a gas leak near the same location, about 150 feet away. That time, it took PG&E hours to clean the whole thing up and pinpoint the exact cause and location of the leak. For more on that part of the story, KCRA3's Chris Riva continues to investigate the history of the intersection live from Roseville.
Well, I got to tell you, it was easy to pinpoint the source of the leak because of the fire itself. In fact, when we rolled onto the scene last night, that's why the Roseville Fire Department said when they arrived to the scene, they simply backed off, let it burn, cleared the area, and start the evacuation process. They said as long as that fire was burning, they knew exactly where the leak was coming. It's hard to believe this intersection was on fire for about 7 hours. You can see the fresh asphalt. It's business as usual back here at the noontime hour here in Roseville. There is fresh asphalt. The big spot right there is where the fire was. There are two smaller spots, one next to the fire and one right here in the intersection where the crosswalk is. That's where they had to dig the hole and pinch the pipe. The cleanup process is something that literally took all night long and into the morning. Crews were here all the way into this morning rush hours. They're trying to get this situation and the intersection completely reopened. But now the investigation centers on why has there been two gas leaks at this intersection within about a year span. It's something the city of Roseville is concerned about, and it's something the PG&E says they are sure to investigate.
I certainly understand the current concerns regarding this location, and that's exactly what we want to do, is do a thorough investigation of the fire that occurred yesterday so that we can understand how and why it occurred, and we will also take into account the situation that occurred approximately 1 year ago.
Walt, 60,000 vehicles rush this section, intersection, through this direction each and every day. The city of Roseville says that they're very concerned about the safety of their citizens. They say their next step is something they've already started. They've contacted PG&E. They're demanding a sit-down meeting with them to get to the bottom of this. PG&E says that this is two separate incidents because of last night's leak was 125 to 150 feet away from the leak that was previously at about a year ago. They continue to maintain that they're going to investigate it. The city of Roseville still is certain. Searching for answers. Live in Roseville, Chris Riva, KCRA3 reports.
Chris, the NTSB part of this investigation? If so, what will they do?
Spoke with them at great length this morning. They said that they're aware of the situation. As you may know, the San Bruno investigation just wrapped up literally days ago. It told me that they're not going to be part of the investigation at this point simply because there weren't any type of injuries or loss of life. They'll continue to monitor the situation. They added, we only have 4 pipeline investigators throughout the country, none of which have been deployed to Roseville just as of yet.